Well, hello everybody and welcome back to another NF reaction video. Now, I know this song isn't on the journey, neither was the last one we checked out, NF Lies and now NF 100, but I've had a lot of you tell me that you want me to react to this song before we move on from this album. Tons of you have asked for it, so I'm not going to disappoint. So I figured, screw it, let's chuck NF 100 on the journey. We've only got, what, two more songs left on this album? Maybe one more? We've got one more song left on this album, actually, and then we got one that's a prelude to The Search. So we've only got one more song left after this, and then we move on. We move on from this album. I feel like this one has flown by way quicker than the last two. Am I right? Is there just less songs on the journey on this album? Really feels like it's blinked by. Anyway! I got a few things I want to say at the beginning of this video. So for those of you who don't know, I record all these videos in advance, right? I've been open about it since the start. I record them all in advance. That's why sometimes I miss milestones or I miss delays or it'll be a few videos late. It's because I work a full-time job during the week, so I have to record these videos around that job. It's just impossible to do it while I'm working. So a lot of these videos are recorded in advance, which is why there's certain delays. That's why I want to start live streaming as well when I get a chance, why I keep trying to tell you guys to go check out my Twitch. Because that way, at least then, there won't be any delays with how we do this. And also, if I can ever do this as a full-time job, obviously that will change, won't it? There'll be no delays. You guys will be able to talk to me directly. But at the moment, that's how it has to be done. So, I need to address a few things now. First, at the moment of recording this video, I'm currently sitting on 9,700 subscribers. If things keep going this way, then by the time this video goes out, I might be over 10k. So this will probably be the first NF video that comes out when I'm over 10k. Obviously, I'm not going to preemptively say thank you because I don't know. Anything can change. It's YouTube. It's a very volatile system. Anything could change. But if for any reason that has happened, I just want to say, well, already, already we broke 9k. Like, I didn't expect that. I did a BTS reaction. I wanted to check out them for the first ever time. They're like one of the biggest bands in the world, so I figured I'd check them out. And I never expected to get so much support from that community. Like, they've been so kind and welcoming. All of you guys are. Every community we've checked out, whether it's Hangover Gang or Creek Squad or The Outcast, and then we checked out Easy Meal, and then I was like, right, let's check these guys out as well. And we checked out BTS, and it just seems like this channel is becoming a place for just people who love music. A really nice community. Everyone's nice to each other. Everyone's polite to each other. Everyone respects each other. It's just become a really nice place. So I just wanted to say, first, thank you so much for getting me to 9K. Wow, that was a jump quickly. And thank you so much for blowing past that number as well. You guys don't realize how emotional I get when the cameras aren't rolling with my wife. You guys actually break my heart in the best way. I hope you understand what I mean by that. But yeah, I just wanted to take a moment before I jump into this video just to say thank you. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey. Thank you so much for checking out the other videos. Some of you stick to Nate. Some of you check out the other reactions I do. And I just appreciate all of you. Some of you, I don't promote it, but I want to say a huge thank you as well to some people who check the description. And there's, like I said, there's a link down to talk about. And thank you so much. If you know, you know. So thank you so much. And also thank you so much for like everything. Those of you who just follow me on Twitch, waiting for a live stream on there, follow me on Instagram. You guys are flipping amazing. Thank you so, so much. I have no idea where this year is going to take us. No idea. But because of you guys, the dream I have of one day making this a job, it's a little bit closer every single day. So from the bottom of my heart, I'm trying not to get emotional. It seems in NF videos I get too emotional anyway. Thank you so much for your support. Anyway, I've spoken for long enough. It's about time we jumped into NF 100. Woo, need to calm down for a second there. Anyway, enough of my waffling bollocks. Let's hit play on this video already. Yeah. I'm on 100 right now. Yeah. Say the flow is sounding like a mixtape. They ain't see it coming like a fast break. They ain't see it coming like Jordan hitting jumpers. Yeah, they asked me when that new music about to drop. Ain't that what I gave you last week? Yeah. This straight off the bat feels very, very different. The thing I keep saying about Nate is Nate is one of these artists where every song, because he's so close to his producer and because they make every song from scratch together, every song is completely unique. a lot of it obviously falls under the same genre, but every song just feels completely unique. You never feel like you're it's like a repetitive album. I don't know if you guys know that. We're like, sometimes you buy a CD and you'll just feel like every song's the same song, or the song's never changed. You never get that with Nate.
Are you done it now? Feels like I'm coming up and spit it like I'm underground. Wonder how I come into your city like I run a town. Let it sound. Started on the stage, now we in the crowd. Yeah, we split the hype though.
That snare bass change. What was that? What was that?
Let it sound. Started on the stage, now we in the crowd. Yeah, we split the hype though. Told me that your record was the greatest, but you lied though. Told me that your city, you a god, yeah, we lied down. Say you.
He constantly does this. He constantly goes after all these rappers that are talking about how awesome they are. And Nate's just like, why are you guys lying? Why are you guys lying? I'm coming to your city and I just wipe the floor with you guys. I love it. I love it because lyrically and like vocally, they're just not on the same level.
Tell me that your record was the greatest, but you lied down. Tell me that your city, you a god, yeah, we lied down. Say you never live until you find something to die for. Woo! Yeah, and then it's so true. Forget the haters, remember people you're close to. Now I'm
100%. No matter what you are, no matter what you do, and it literally could be anything from an office job like I do outside of this, from a construction worker. There's always gonna be hate, people with hatred in their hearts, people with like haters, if you want to call them that. I don't really like saying that, but yeah, there's always gonna be that. Always, it doesn't matter what you do. Always gonna be that in your life. But forget those people. They're not worth your time. Don't give them any of your energy. Just let them. Let it be a one-sided fight for them. Let them just put all their energy into disliking you for no particular reason, and you just let it brush off you and continue with your life. Let it consume their life, man. It doesn't need to affect yours.
Doing things they told me I ain't supposed to. They treat me like a player. That's funny. I'm here to coach you.
They treat me like a player. That's funny. I'm here to coach you. Love it.
Go back to the bench now where you belong. Say that you've been practicing. Well, maybe you should do it more. Say that
I'm loving the basketball references in this one as well, man. It's like, it started open up with the Jordan lineup bar, and now it's moving on to this as well. It's like, there's so many basketball references.
Go back to the bench now where you belong. Say that you've been practicing. Well, maybe you should do it more. Say that you're the boss. Yeah, well, who did you employ? All these sucky rappers, I don't listen to them. So annoyed. I'm on 100. Yeah, I said I'm on 100 right now, eh?
Wait a second. Wait a second. Part of me just now feels like this song should be on the journey. Because in, what song is this? It's Therapy Session, right? In Therapy Session, doesn't he say something like, you guys want to see me at 100? I promise you, if that's what you want, then that's what you're going to get. Is that Therapy Session? Is that the bar? I'm just saying, and even now, I'm on 100. I'm on 100. I'm just saying, Therapy Sessions, if that's true, what I've just said there, then Therapy Session and this song connect. And Therapy Session references this song later on. I'm just saying. He says, if you guys want to see me on 100, then I promise what you're going to get. And here we are with Perception, and boom. 100.
I'm on 100. Yeah, I said I'm on 100 right now, eh? We on 100. Yeah, I said we on 100 right now.
Man, this is a hood up, walking down the street, lost in your own thoughts, screw the world kind of song. This, man, this is that kind of song to get you in that kind of mood. It's time to go into the octagon.
On 100 right now, eh? We on 100. Yeah, I said we on 100 right now. Eh? Yeah, you should have left us on a high note. Different city, different time zones. You had me open up for your tour. I leave it looking like it's my show. The fans begging for the encore. Woo!
I love that. I love that. I love that. I love that. Have me open up for your tour. I'll leave the thinking like it's my show. Man, I've had that before at a gig as well. I saw Disturbed and Avenged Sevenfold tour together. And Disturbed opened for Avenged Sevenfold. And I'm not joking when I say this, man. Disturbed destroyed the show. I love Avenged Sevenfold. And they came out and I was actually there like, yeah, man, this is good, but can you bring Disturbed back out? have you guys had a gig like that before where the opening band just absolutely destroyed the headliner?
Yeah, and what you know about selling merchandise right out your house. I got 40 boxes in my living room on the couch. Yeah, me and my girl about to ship them out. Oh, Lord.
The girl, me and my girl about to ship them out. Is that the same lovely lady in his life right now who is the mother of his son?
Yeah, I thought I told him last record. I'm out here grinding on a mad level. Always on 100, they don't understand the mad hustle. Nah, but that's what happens when the fans love you. I know. Yeah, I ain't the norm, but I like it though. About to move the family out to Nashville. I'm sleeping on the floor, got no curtains in the bedroom. Hang up the sheets, yeah, that's the way that I roll.
I love this. I love this because he talks about this a lot, and it goes to show that even on his third album, money is still a bit iffy. And I think that is because, from what it sounds like, Nate prioritized his family over himself when he got those first paychecks. He wanted to give his family a nice house, a nice life. He wanted to make sure that they didn't want for anything. That's what I'm getting from it. And it seems like he literally, the money came in and he just pushed it straight out. It wasn't for him. He's, you know, he slept on the floor of the booth or in hotel rooms or when he was recording albums, whatever. It's like the money was nothing to him. He wears the same hoodie for out an album, wears the same top, doesn't care, doesn't change his clothes. It's literally just like he's here for music and nothing else. And the money is irrelevant. And I absolutely, absolutely love the guy for that.
Yeah, I think the money about to change me. That type of talking got me angry, yeah. A lot of people trying to play me. Me and the fan base looking like the A-team. Ooh, how you telling people that we family? Hold up. Yeah, when you ain't even mad me. That's the type of thing that may have sad me. Yeah, that's the type of thing that may have sad me. I'm on 100. Yeah.
Who's he talking about when he says, how you telling people that we're family, you ain't even met me, that's the kind of thing that upsets me? Who is he talking about? Who is he talking about when he said that bar? Is there someone specific that that's aimed to? Is it like some an old family member he hasn't spoken to that's like come out and said something and he's wrote that bar for them? Huh? Maybe? I don't know. You guys let me know down below.
100. Yeah, I said I'm on 100 right now, eh? We on 100. Yeah, I said we on 100 right now, eh? I'm on 100.
Ah, man, this song, man.
Yeah, I said I'm on 100 right now, eh?
Are you guys ready? Let's rewind it. Are you guys ready?
I'm on 100.
Man, that song! Ah, we've had so many good ones recently. Reception is an awesome album. I'm just saying. I am just saying. This album is awesome. Lies, the last song we checked out, Lies, literally felt like it resonated with me. And then this song, well, these are two songs that just, like, 100 especially is a pump-up song. Big time. What I would say for, like, the journey going ahead, because obviously Lies you don't need on the journey. You don't need it on the journey. But 100, I feel like this links to Therapy Session when he says, if you guys want to see me at 100, then I promise you that's what I'll get. Like, that bar. I swear he says that, right? Right? He does. I'm pretty sure he does. And if that's correct, then I feel like this song links to Therapy Session. I feel like it should be on the journey. Because he says, if you guys want to see me at 100, I promise that's what you'll get. And then this song comes out, and he's talking, I'm on 100. It links. So if I was to add any song to the journey we've checked out, I'd add this one. I'd definitely add this one. I'd love to say I'd add Oh Lord, just because it's an absolutely beautiful song. But it isn't really related, at least in my opinion. Maybe you guys disagree with me on that. But 100, I feel like it is. I feel like it should be If You Want Love, and then 100. That's how I'd like have the journey. I definitely feel like this should be on the journey. Because I think it really shows the progression, how he's feeling. He's talking about where he is and talking about money. I feel like it does show the progression in it. Are you guys watching this right now going, nah, you're totally wrong, I totally disagree with you? If you do feel like that, let me know. Because like I said, this is a discussion. This isn't a one-way street. My opinion is just that, and your opinion is that. And we'll you know, let me know what you guys think, and I'm happy to hear it. That's just what I'm feeling. Yeah, man, that was a song to get you in a mood. That was a song to get you in a mood. That was good. Ah, oh, man, I'm glad I checked that one out. I'm glad I checked it out. But anyway, we've got two more now. We've got two more coming up. We've got one more song left on this journey. Is it Remember Something? Remember This? Is that the last one? Remember Me? And then we got No Name. I think those are the two left, right? And I think the Remember one is on the album, and No Name is the prelude to The Search. Now, for those of you wondering, when we hit the search, I'm going to do the whole album, the entire album, because every single list, every single flipping journey list I've been given by you guys says a list of search songs, but then they all say the same thing, which is, to be honest, you should probably listen to every song on the search because of how the album connects. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to listen to every single song on the search. You guys ready for that? Are you guys ready? If you haven't already, subscribe for the journey, my friends. Subscribe for the journey. Also, if we have hit 10K by the time this video is going out, if we have to hit 10K, and for some reason, I think this video is, 20 minutes long, and you guys have made it this far in the video, then this is an exclusive for all of you watching right now. There are some things coming. I wanted to work on this when I hit 9K, between the grind to 9 to 10K, but that kind of came a lot quicker than I thought it would, so I'm having to work on it as this video is being recorded, which is some new artwork, some new designs for the second channel. That's right, the second channel. You guys, and what you're going to get on this second channel is literally everything you don't get on this channel. You're going to get those live streams on YouTube as well as the ones on Twitch. So any other stream on Twitch will be re-uploaded to that channel as well. You're going to get me reacting to all sorts of other stuff related to behind the scenes interviews regarding NF, Tom McDonald, Upchurch, everybody, Upchurch documentary. You're going to get all those videos. All, basically, I want to keep this channel exclusively music, and the other channel is going to be everything else. The Tom McDonald trailers you guys keep telling me to check out. All that stuff is going on that channel. All of it. And as well as that, you're going to get vlogs about my home life. And whenever I got the time to record one, you guys will get some vlogs. There's a couple of ones I've already got ready. And you're going to get a bunch of wife reaction videos. So if that channel's already out by the time this video comes out, I don't think it will be, then you might want to go check it out. You might want to go check it out, because trust me, there's going to be some awesome videos on that channel. And this one's going to stay exclusively music. Anyway, that's a little exclusive, anyone who watched the video the whole way through. I love you guys! You should know that by now. And as always, you will see me in the next video!